Greetings everyone and welcome to the Druid's Grove. Tonight, we will talk about Ahura Mazda. Ahura Mazda is a supreme god in the ancient Iranian religion. Especially, Zoroastrianism, the religious system of the Iranian prophet Zarathustra. The Persian consider him to be the creator of earth, the heavens and humankind, as well as the sources of all goodness and happiness on earth. He was known to later Zoroastrians as Ahurmazd. He created the twin spirits Spentamainu and Angramainu, the former beneficent, choosing truth, light and life, and the later destructive, choosing deceit, darkness and death. The struggle of the spirits against each other makes up the history of the world and is reflected in the choice between good and evil that humanity constantly faces. Ahura Mazda appears in Persian art and text as a bearded man, wearing a robe covered with stars, dwelling high in heaven. He had the sun for an eye. In the Zoroastrian religion, Ahura Mazda was associated with light and fire, that emblems of truth, goodness and wisdom. He created six divine beings or angels to help him spread goodness and govern the universe. The early Zoroastrians had a dualic system of belief in which two opposing and equal forces, good and evil, battle for control of the world. Ahura Mazda, originally called Spentamainu, represented light, truth and goodness. His great enemy was his twin brother, Angramainu, also known as Ahriman, the god of darkness, anger and death. Later Zoroastrians considered Ahura Mazda to be the more powerful force who'd ultimately triumph over the evil Ahriman. Central to Zoroaster's view of Ahura Mazda was the concept of Asha, meaning truth. In the extended sense, Asha refers to the equitable law of the universe, which governed the life of Zoroaster's people, the nomadic herdsmen of Central Asian steppes. Asha was the course of everything observable, the motion of planets and astral bodies, the progression of season, the pattern of daily nomadic herdsman life, and governor of metronomic events such as sunrise and sunset. All physical creation, Geti, was created and maintained according to a larger divine plan attributed to Ahura Mazda. Violation of the order, Druj, were violation against creation, and thus, transgression against Ahura Mazda. In Zoroaster's original teachings, Ahura Mazda was the transcendent entity which actually existed above the opposite forces of Asha and Druj. This concept of Asha versus the Druj should not be confused with the good versus evil battle evident in Western religions. Although both forces of dualism express moral conflict, the Asha versus Druj concept is more suitable and nuanced, representing, for instance, chaos that opposes order or uncreation that opposing creation. According to Zoroaster teachings, while Ahura Mazda is seen as the one uncreated, creator of all, he is not also seen as the creator of Druj, for as anti-creation, the Druj are not created. In Zoroaster's revelation, Ahura Mazda will ultimately triumph, but cannot control the Druj. As such, Zoroaster did not perceive Ahura Mazda to be root of evil, nor was he considered wholly omnipotent. Throughout the Gathas scriptures, Zoroaster emphasizes deeds and actions, for it is only throughout good thoughts, good words, good deeds that order can be maintained. In Zoroaster's revelation, it is indeed the paramount purpose of mankind to assist in maintaining the order Ahura Mazda was created. In Yasna 45:9, Ahura Mazda has left the people wills to choose between doing good, that is living under a regimen of good thoughts, good words and good deeds, and doing evil, living with bad thoughts, bad words and bad deeds. The concept of a free will is perhaps Zoroaster's greatest contribution to the Persian religious philosophy. Thank you for listening to me, Seekers of Knowledge. If you enjoyed my video, please subscribe. And till the next time, have a great day or night. Goodbye.